фізицист. В мене, я перш за все хотів щиро подякувати за дуже змістовний аналіз, дуже переконливий. І в мене таке питання. Чи розуміють, ну, на вашу опінію, чи розуміють в Європі, що, що зараз почався процес, так би мовити, ремейку СССР, ремейку...
Ресовкізації.
СССР.
Ну, імперії колишні. Ну, і ізоляція України є важливим елементом цієї стратегії відновлення...
Ну, імперії.
Колишньої імперії, скажімо імперії, так.
Да.
І, мабуть, я висловлю загальну опінію, що ми просимо Європу не підтримувати ці ізоляціоністські тенденції, ага, не допомагати ізолювати нас формі. Від Європи. Дякую.
Они так сами
это Well, I think that in terms of supporting isolation of Ukraine, certainly there is no intention to do that. What I think is very important is that the Ukrainian people and the Ukrainian civil society are those who have the highest responsibility to express clearly what they expect for their country and what they want for their country. So don't expect also outsiders to, let's say, replace you in these obligations. In terms of isolation, we are not talking about isolation now. We are talking about completing an agreement, negotiation. We are talking about signing, ratifying. But as I said, Ukraine has to demonstrate that it is ready for such an agreement, that it is that it deserves such an agreement. As I often say, I don't know if I said it or not, this is not a double standard. There is no country in the European Union who came from an authoritarian regime, and I think of the 27 countries today, I would say that at least half, maybe even more, came from such background, be it from the west to the central to the eastern part of Europe. And all these countries, in a matter of 1 to 2 years, had one constitution, normally through an electoral, a constitutional assembly elected by the people. They had conducted elections which were on the first go considered to be free, fair, representative, where the new leaders cooperated even in different parts of the political spectrum to reach their European objectives. So Ukraine is being given these agreements without meeting these conditions yet. So we are, I think, doing more for Ukraine than it was done for any other country. But the citizens, the civil society cannot be passive, indifferent, and waiting for others to build your democracy. The democracy needs the people who want the democracy, and it's the leaders who want the democracy. And I think this is the very big difference that I see between Ukraine and other countries which went through democratization processes. The people were demanding, and the leaders that arose from the, let's say, to the new system were often themselves prosecuted by the previous system. They were either in jail or in exile, and they therefore there was a communion of leadership and people mobilization to reach these objectives.